Keep this to simple physics. This essentially is a curb bit. First, you know, we're kind of really pinching on her jaw, but it's just a lever. And I use the crowbar analogy. The shorter the purchase, the faster and more leverage you have. You lengthen the purchase, you kind of dull the bit, slow things down. And a perfect analogy to that is a team roper running down the arena. You know, he doesn't want a bit that he kind of checks a horse, the horse is going to scotch. So you need a duller, slower acting bit. They can check them up and not get to take hold of the horse too much. And it's the same way, it's back to the crowbar analogy. It's just like a crowbar. You know, if you're going to pick something up, you know, your fulcrum, the closer you put it to the end of the crowbar, the more leverage you have. It's quicker acting. The further you move it out, the more effort it takes on the end to pick something up, and you have to go further. So, like I said, keep it to simple mechanics first. The port, essentially all this, you're going to always have a straight line from the center of the headstall loop to the butt of the mouthpiece. Now you can change, you can put a little more metal on one side or the other, but it's not going to affect the balance. You just can't move that much more metal to change how a bit balances on your purchase. That's the reason you have curved shanks, the cavalry shank, the S-turn. All that does is...
My favorite bit that I go to show in is this bit here, and for the reason I like having quite a bit of purchase on my show horses myself, just because I feel like whenever it grabs them a little higher on the chin, when I pick my hand up, I feel like it gives me that the feel of them coming back to me that I want to feel.
There's industry standards, you know, and a lot of the bit makers, they all, you know, everybody talks about the ratio, and the ratio of the length of the shank and of the purchase. And there's, you know, there's 2-to-1, 3-to-1, and that's usually, you know, whatever the distance is here, twice, 2.5 times that, it's usually your shank length, the cheek's overall length. And, you know, I don't worry too much about ratios. I don't think it's that critical. As long as you build a bit that's comfortable to the horse with common sense dimensions,